And welcome to this second part of the tutorial series on MPFB materials. This video supposes that you have a working installation of MPFB. It is also assumed that you have watched the first part in the series. If either of these are not true, please refer to the other videos linked from the description. In this video, we will concentrate on the Make Skin and Game Engine materials. Both of these are mostly texture-based. As a quick recap, the traditional way of creating detailed materials are via image textures. A material will in this approach consist of one image which provides the colors of the surface. Combined with this are other images which control things such as reflectivity, normals, and transparency. The opposite of an image-based material is a procedural material. Such materials will be covered in later parts of this tutorial series. Make Skin has some minor procedural aspects though, mostly to provide color adjustment functionality. How to use this will be explained. Then I will provide a brief demo on how to create ImageMat material descriptors and how to use these as a basis for Make Skin alternative materials for assets. Finally, I will give some hints on what needs to be considered when exporting a character with a game engine material. Let's begin with setting the scope of the video. As said in the first part, you can choose which material to use when applying assets on the Apply Assets and Library Settings panel. What we will be talking about are the generic materials which are used for clothes. Here, the two available options are Make Skin and Game Engine. What might not be obvious is that almost all attachable meshes, such as hair and tongue, will also use the material model we select here. That is because, technically, there is no difference between a tongue and a t-shirt. They are both clothes in an MPFB context. For the sake of this video, it does not matter which material you want to use here. They will look exactly the same, as they are both image-based materials. But let's burrow deeper into image-based materials to begin with. In the image, you can see one of the system assets, the male casual suit 01. Here you can see the various image components together and isolated. In the first image, you can see the asset as it looks with both the diffuse and normal map textures applied. As a reminder, when you hear the term diffuse, you can think color. In the second image, you can see how the asset looks when having removed the normal map. If you look closely, you can see that some wrinkles have gone missing. In the third image, you can see the asset without the diffuse texture. Here, only the normal map is applied in the material. Note especially the shape of the belt. In the final image, you can see how the bare mesh looks without any material. Here you can see that there are no wrinkles and that the belt part is mostly not visible. If you compare the first and the last image, you can get an impression of how much difference a good material does. Trying to achieve the same kind of detail by modeling the mesh would require some significant effort. If we take a closer look at the diffuse and normal map images, we can see how they look in raw form. The image on the left contributes the colors, while the image on the right faked topology on the mesh to cause shadows as if there was geometry there. In Blender, you can switch to the Shading tab to see the shader node setup for a material. For the image-based materials, you can see that the diffuse and the normal map image textures are connected to a principled node. Since this is a Make Skin material, there are also some placeholders for other things, but we will get into that later. With this background, let's delve into the actual materials. As indicated by the title of this video, the materials we are talking about are generic. That is, they can be used for any mesh in MPFB. The most obvious is that clothes will have image-based materials. You can also use Make Skin or Game Engine for both body skin and eyes. This will make sense in many cases. Make Skin is the default option for materials for all types of meshes, since this is what will cause the least amount of surprises. If you did not choose otherwise, a character created with MPFB will be using Make Skin for everything. Taking a look at exactly which images can be used in the material, we can see that Make Skin supports a lot, while Game Engine supports less. We will not get into all of these textures. Suffice to say that there is a lot to play with if you want to create materials. In the end of the video, there will be a section on how to create MixSkin materials. We will take a closer look at some of these textures then. As we saw in the table, Game Engine is rather limited. Actually, Game Engine is a slimmed down version of MakeSkin, where everything that was likely to cause trouble in external applications was removed. Game Engine only supports three image texture types, namely color, normal, and transparency. This might sound limiting, but then one has to bear in mind that very few of the available assets use anything else. In almost all situations in Blender, an asset with the Game Engine material will look exactly the same as an asset with the MakeSkin material. It should be noted, though, that MakeSkin also provides some additional control, which we will get into shortly. For continuing, we should also note that although the materials we talk about here are image-based, that is not the same as saying that they can only be controlled with images. If there is no texture for an aspect, then the corresponding property of the principal node will be used. This is particularly common for roughness. Most assets do not provide an image for controlling the roughness. Instead, they set a global value for the entire asset. As I've been mentioned a few times, MakeSkin supports some minor procedural tweaks. The one you might have the most use of is the color control. By using this, you can override color components of the diffuse texture while still retaining transparency and add other texture inputs such as normal map. This override will be saved when saving a character. Color overrides are best done in the shader nodes view. Here we have the system asset long01 hair equipped. Say that we want the hair to be darker than the provided brown color. We can then decide to mix the color component of the texture with black. Then we can control how much black to use by manipulating the factor of the mix node. When you save the character the next time, these settings will be stored. While the color control feature might be convenient in simple cases, it will only get you so far. If you want better control over color, you would provide a different diffuse texture. We will use this alternative material for the casual suit as an example. This is, by the way, one of the many excellent alternative materials made by Margaret Toigo, and which are available for download as asset packs. A material often consists of four files. Two we have already mentioned, the diffuse texture and the normal map. Then there is an icon in the form of a thumbnail. For materials, this is mostly used on the asset pack's webpage to show off how the material will look. Finally, there is a cryptic-looking file with the extension mhmat. Mhmat files describe MakeSkin materials and can also be used as spaces for Game Engine materials. It is a very simple file format, which basically lists which texture to use and the values of global properties. This is also the original material format used by MakeHuman, thus the name MakeHuman Material. If we open the mhmat file in any text editor, such as Notepad, we will see that it lists some properties which roughly translates into settings of the principal node. Then it refers to the two image textures. A mesh asset can have any number of these materials. In MPFB, they will show up as alternative materials. If you did not install any other asset packs than the system assets, you will still have a few eye colors to choose between. But let's equip Toigo's khaki material. Now that we know what alternative materials are, we might be interested in knowing how to create them. Luckily for us, the tools required for creating materials are bundled with MPFB. If you create the appropriate material files and store them in the same asset folder as the mesh asset they are for, then they will show up in the Alternative Materials dropdown when the asset is selected. Let's start with something simple. This is the female sportsuit 01 from the System Assets pack. If we switch to the texture paint tab, we can see that it currently has a diffuse texture and a simple UV layout. Now, our goal here is to create a completely new material. So we start by removing the one currently on the asset. Make sure you remove the material, not only blank it. Now we can find the Make Skin toolset, which is under Create Assets. The first we see is a panel where we can select which textures to create placeholders for in a new empty material. Since we only want to do something simple, we're satisfied with the diffuse texture. We can also choose to create actual images. We will choose to do so and be satisfied with a 2K by 2K resolution. If you want finer details, you'd opt for a larger resolution here. We now have a new material with a solid black image for diffuse. The goal now is to create a white suit with a yellow smiley face. So we start by painting the suit white. To make life easier, we will also enable X symmetry. This way, we only need to paint one side. While we paint the mesh, we can see that the diffuse texture image gets populated on the left side. It is not that important to catch all spots here. We will touch up the parts that it seems we missed directly on the image. Now we can start painting our smiley face. For the sake of the tutorial, I'm just doing something quick here. In reality, one would probably spend more effort on getting it to look right. That we'll have to do for now. Back in the Make Skin tool, we can enter a name and a description. We will ignore the Make Human specific settings for now. If you intend to use the material in Make Human, you can take a closer look at these. Now, all that remains is to save the material in the library. To test it, we will remove the material again. You will find the material under Alternative Materials. This is how you create a simple material consisting only of a color. Next, we will do something more exotic with eyes. By selecting the eyes and going to the Texture Paint tab, you can see that there is nothing magic with these. It is the same setup with a diffuse texture as for clothes. We begin the same way as with the clothes and remove the existing material. The goal now is to create eyes that shine in the dark. To achieve this, we opt to create three different textures: diffuse, emission color, and emission strength. We will hide the other meshes in the viewport so we can see what we are doing. When working with textures of this kind, it is best to be in viewport shading mode. We will start with the diffuse texture. A red background seems suitable. We will also enable X symmetry. Let's paint the eyeballs red to begin with. Next, we will paint the emission color. This is the color of the light shining from the eyes. Here, we will use a trick. Tab to enter edit mode and hit A to select all. Then tab again to go back to texture paint mode. This way, you will see the UV layout in the image view. This will give us a guide that helps us when painting. We will start with the red iris. Next, we will go for a yellow center of the eye. The next step is the strength of the emission. Here, black is no light shining and white is 1.0 light shining. We will make both the iris and eye center shine. Now, we can go back to the viewport and enable the other meshes again. It looks like the eyes are shining, but let's reduce the other lights to see better. Rendering, we'll get something that looks like shiny eyes. The next steps would be the same as for the clothes. Save as an alternative, and you can pick up the material from the alternative material dropdown with the eyes selected. In the final part of the video, I will provide some hints regarding materials when exporting characters. The first is that exotic things like shiny eyes are very unlikely to work outside Blender. So we will create a new character. But before doing so, we will make sure that we use the game engine material model. We do nothing special when creating the character, just add everything as usual. Selecting an item and entering the shader tab, we can see that things look slightly different. Here, the color control node is missing, and the diffuse texture has been duplicated so that the color and alpha sockets are connected to separate texture instances. In the external application, this will make things show up as if they were separate textures. What to export depends on what you want to achieve, but here I will assume that you only want to export the character, so we select everything related to the character. Then we open the Export to FBX panel. The path stuff is what will make all the difference. You will most likely want to use the copy option here to save the textures together with the file you export. In many cases, it also makes sense to put the textures inside the file you export. Here we will indicate that we want to export the selected objects. You will likely have to experiment with different settings to get it right though. Anyway, this concludes the tutorial. Thank you for watching and happy modeling.